Okay, this is the last introductory video. Before we get into the actual stuff that really is the exciting part, where you're going to look at examples, start writing your own code, start making stuff, coming up with your own ideas, trying things out. Before you start making things, I just want to give you an overview as to what my plan is for all of these videos. So there's a key thing here. I'm gonna get some energy back here. Run in place. Okay, there's a key thing here. I want these videos to cover the fundamentals of computation, the fundamental building blocks of computer programming. And really, there is a short list of things that you need to know and understand. There are these core elements that will go across any type of software development, creative coding, computer science, whatever you want to call it. Writing code on your computer. And really, actually, three categories. So, any computer program that runs needs to have data associated with it, right? It needs to store information about itself. Colors. I wish I didn't do this, but just to think about game programming for a second, if you were creating the game Space Invaders, you might need to keep track of the spaceship's position on the screen, which level is the game on, what's the current player's score. There are elements of data that a computer program needs to keep in mind as it's running, and this is actually one of the first things we will learn about, which is this concept of a variable, this thing that stores data. I'm going to go out of order here. In addition to this idea of a variable, which is an individual piece of data, okay, don't worry, everything's okay. There's a floor, and I just dropped the cap. In addition to a variable, which is an individual piece of data, we're also going to learn about something called an array, which we could also think of as a list. So what about a list of data? Instead of a spaceship has an individual location, what if there are 10 enemies on the screen? Could we have a list of enemy locations? So any computer program needs to store data. We're going to learn about variables and arrays. The other thing that we need to really learn about is this idea of control. How do we control the flow of a computer program? How do we control the path by which it takes, right? If the spaceship, I wish I could think of something less violent, shoots its laser and hits the enemy, its score goes up, right? How do we control how do we control that process? I don't know. If the player drops a seed and a flower blooms, that's a nicer way of thinking about it. So, and we want to look at this idea of conditionals, conditional logic, if statements. If this condition is met, then the program executes this instruction, right? That's something we're going to look at. Another control structure we're going to look at is a loop, right? This idea of repeating something. If we have 100 enemy spaceships, do we want to have 100 lines of code? Draw spaceship 1, draw spaceship 2, draw spaceship 3. No, we want to have this loop. Draw every spaceship. For every spaceship, draw it on the screen. So this is this idea, really simple. These are these fundamentals, and we're going to have a set of videos about each one of these. How do we deal with a variable? How do we deal with a conditional? How do we deal with a loop? How do we deal with an array? But another thing that's going to be very primary to this video series is thinking about organizing, organization. Thinking about how you organize your code. So when we first start, we're going to be writing very simple instructions. Line, fill, which is set a color, rectangle, ellipse, just for drawing stuff on the screen. But as we write larger and larger programs, we need to encapsulate ideas into kind of their own mini programs in a way. So the two kind of key principles of organization that we're going to look at is how to write a function. What if we figure out a nice way of drawing a flower pattern on the screen, right? I can't draw. This is a flower, right? If we figure out how to draw a flower and then we want to have 10 flowers on the screen, are we going to rewrite all of the code for drawing the flower 10 times? Maybe that was 100 lines of code just to get this pattern. Could we just take this entire idea of a flower and put it in its own function so that anytime we want a flower on the screen, we have a new command, so to speak. We can just say flower. And even more than this idea of functions, a key principle we want to look at is objects. Object-oriented programming. This, to me, is one of the ways that I really started to feel comfortable writing software, is once I got to the point of learning object-oriented programming and understanding something and the screen treating it in this way that we look at the world. This is an object. This object has data associated with it. Its color is black. It is a dry erase marker. That's maybe its piece of data rather than a permanent marker. And it has functionality. This thing I could say, draw. I could take its cap on and off, right? Remove cap, add cap. So this idea of taking something like a flower and turning it into an object. There's data about this flower. How big is it? How small is it? What color is it? And it might have functionality. It could grow. The petals could fall. So this idea of something happening in a computer graphics application being packaged up into this object. Now, this sounds very theoretical and grand and or perhaps confusing right now, but we're going to get into the details of how to take a program which has variables and conditionals and loops and all this logic and all this data and how to organize it into a way that we can just say, hey, there are seed objects and there are flower objects and there is grass objects and there, if we're creating some type of garden simulation, for example. So these are all of the things we want to learn at. And some programming courses, something like object-oriented programming, might be something that comes very, very late in the game, almost at the very end, or perhaps in like a second semester even as an advanced topic. But we're going to get to objects pretty quickly because I want that to be a fundamental way that we look at creating examples and creating projects in processing. So this is kind of, this is the list of fundamentals, right? These are kind of computer science fundamentals. Ah, I use the word computer science. I just like demerit. My goal is to like never mention the term computer science in any of these videos. Anyway, I'll go off on that rant or tangent. Not rant, I don't like to rant. But anyway, edit this out, please, somebody. Okay, so these are kind of the fundamentals, the things that will transfer to any programming language and environment. These are the sort of core elements, and we want to understand these in great detail without any fear or sadness. We just want to feel happy and comfortable about all these things and start to practice writing programs. But once we get through this, I also want to take a look at some applications. So what are some types of things that one might do? For example, I really want to look at images. How do we load images and draw images to the screen? How do we read the pixels of an image and manipulate and do image processing? How do we do the kinds of things that might happen in a piece of software like Photoshop? How do we write that stuff from scratch with code? What happens if we use a moving image, like a camera or a video? Can we do things like computer vision? How do we write software that can find somebody's face? How do we write software that can track the skeleton of the human body with the Kinect? So I want to have sort of a set of videos about images and pixels. I also want to look at data as a topic. So what does it mean to load data into a program? What are the kinds of ways of loading data? There's plain text and XML and JSON and there are all sorts of data classes in processing that allow you to load data, parse data, and draw stuff based on that data. So what does it mean to connect to data that's local versus data that's on a server? I want to look at a whole set of examples. What does it mean to work with text strings? What does it mean to read a novel and count all the words in that novel, to do a concordance? So I want to have a set of videos that deal with data. And I haven't made these videos yet, so I totally don't know exactly what I'm going to do. We could think about, what about 3D graphics? So I guess what I meant is like topics. So this video series is going to start with the fundamentals, all the fundamental tools of computation. And in there, we're also going to have to learn about pixels and drawing and color and shape, some basic computer graphic stuff. But really, we're going to focus on these fundamental core concepts of computation. And from there, once we have all this bag of tricks, we're going to reinforce those ideas, do them over and over again, practice with them through a set of topics. Images, pixels, data, 3D graphics, I could come up with some others, but this is a pretty good starting point right now. Integration with the web, perhaps. What is this landscape of Could we do stuff with processing on the web? And is there this thing called processing.js, which is JavaScript? I might try to look at that at some point in a video series. So just to give you, I think I'm kind of done with talking about this, but just to kind of like walk through the order, this is going to help me. You can stop now. I'm just going to organize my own thoughts and I'm going to keep recording. Why not, right? This might be a bad idea. Okay, we're in the intro videos right now. So we're kind of going to be done with the intro videos. And actually, there's something right before that, which is sort of the basics of drawing and processing, which we're going to start with. I'll call this like one. This will be two. Once we get through the basics of drawing, we're going to look at variables. That'll be the sort of videos called number three. Then this would be like if this were a course, if you were taking a class, if this were anything other than just me in this weird room rambling to... Then this would be like week one, week two, week three. And in fact, these videos are intended to go along with this course that I am teaching here, which is divided into weeks. So and this would really actually be week one, intro and drawing. I'll keep that. So this would be variables. Then we're going to look at conditionals and loops. After that, we will get to arrays. I think I got this right. And then after that, we will look at functions. After that, we will look at objects. So it's kind of like half a semester, 6 weeks. And this is grossly accelerated in many ways. You need a lifetime to really master all this stuff. I need lots more time myself. But this will be a kind of six-week video sections through all these topics. And again, after that, 7 would be images, 8 would be data, maybe I'll do that in a different order, 9 would be 3D graphics. So we will kind of get to all of this stuff. This hopefully gives you a nice overview. Kind of wrapped up this introductory stuff. I feel like these were challenging videos to make in the sense that they're very... kind of it's less kind of how-to and looking at stuff step by step and more just kind of rambling through general concepts, and I feel like I missed so many things that I meant to say. So someday I may go back and add things in or write some stuff in the descriptions. But if something is missing or something is confusing you, please, or at this point I guess your way to interact is use the Vimeo comments. Write a comment, ask a question there, and I will we can start with a dialogue that way. The videos may end up also somewhere else embedded into some sort of site that has them as well. Okay, so that's that. So I will see you another time. I thank you. I bid you adieu. Because apparently I'm getting into some French stuff in these videos. Okay, au revoir.